I mean, right. it wasn't a jink jink.
Jink I'm gonna jink, hear. I'm jink. Gonna listen to a little snippet of it.
It didn't have jink 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 jink. No, but it didn't have a jink 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 jink. Jink.
I got you. Don't be getting technical on me now. I'm gonna play a little snippet of it. All right.
I don't understand the jinka jinka. How do you spell that?
It's not even not very carefully.
Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode of Into the Music. My name is Greg. That guy over there is Chris. And Chris, I really like that red shirt on you, man. Good color on you.
Thank you. Thank you. I picked it out myself, and I know it matches my face.
Your red face. Yeah.
My nose, anyway.
Well, because it looks good on you, makes me think that you're bringing it today. That you got on this Zoom recording,
you know, red,
and you're bringing it, right? Here. So hopefully you're going to bring a really good song for me to listen to.
Well, it's really not up to me. It's up to whoever does the song, right? So, okay, I've got a song for you. It's a request through our Ko-fi site. It's a request from Bob, and the name of the band is Great or Person. I'm not sure. I wasn't able to find it. Is Greyboy featuring Quantic and Sharon Jones, and the name of the song is Got to Be a Love.
Wow. Okay.
It's a mouthful, I know, but all that. But
I don't recognize any of the performers, the people, who did this. Yeah. Okay. So cool. Right, so and Bob?
It'll all be new to you.
Bob, thank you for another request. And I'll come back.
It might suck.
It might suck. I don't know. We'll see. We'll find out. We keep it real.
Then you'll thank him and say, gee, Bob, thanks a lot. We'll find out.
We'll find out. Stay tuned. Wow, that was a hip shaker, hip mover. Definitely get you onto the dance floor. I probably would be moving it and shaking it if I wasn't on camera and with the headphones attached. That was really good. Good first listen. Yeah, let's talk with Chris about this.
Hey, I'm back. I'm back from listening to Got to Be a Love. I like that song title. I liked a lot of the song. This was cool. This was just a how do I not like a song that is, it's funk, you know, it's got that dance beat, you know, but it's not like, you know, a pop dance beat. It's got that funky soul kind of dance beat. Mm-hmm. It's kind of seems to be a throwback, and you'll tell me what year. Because it seemed to have, it had that sort of old time sound, soul, sort of late '60s, early '70s.
That sounded to me just like right out of the '70s.
But then I thought there was some like recent day sort of technology, maybe some mixed in or something. Or
it had the you know. Yeah, I heard that where I don't know what it's called, where they moved the record on the turntable back and forth to get that scratchy sound.
Yep.
Probably called the record the turntable.
So you heard that too. Okay. So there was some elements of the song
in the '70s.
So there was some elements of the song that made me think that this was something. Yeah, but overall,
even the singing sounded like something from out of the '70s. And the voice sounded familiar. I don't really have much information on the, you know, who's actually performing on this.
Wow. Okay.
I don't have a lot.
Okay.
But I do know that it came out in 2004, so it's a retro kind of
Okay, thing. Retro. Yeah. All right, retro.
And cool.
Did the song remind you? Did the song remind you of another song?
Not of another song, just the singer's voice reminded me of another singer, but I can't put my, I don't remember who.
The song definitely reminded me of Who Do You Love? It had that. It was like, it got to the point where the second or third time around when she sang, I was waiting for like, you know, who do you love? Who do you love?
Really?
Yeah. I mean,
it didn't have a Bo Diddley kind of rhythm though.
It had a beat. It there was something to it that just made me, yeah. I mean, right. It wasn't a jink, jink, jink.
I'm going to listen to a little snippet of it.
It didn't have jink, 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 jink. No. It didn't have that chicka 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 chicka.
I got you. Don't be getting technical on me now. I'm gonna play a bit of it, all right?
I don't understand the chicka chicka. How do you spell that?
It's not even not very carefully. Okay. All right, here we go. That's what you're talking about?
No, but when she sings.
What?
Pull it back. Ooh, what? No, that's not Bo Diddley when she's like, you know, that just.
That's the part.
Who do you love?
Oh my God, I think you're stretching it, but okay, if that's what you hear.
Well, maybe the George Thorogood.
You don't hear that, so
maybe the Thorogood. You know, that got tired. Who do you love?
I'm not saying you're wrong. I'm just saying I don't pick up on.
I wasn't even struggling to even like. Oh, it's got to sound like something. It just came into my head.
Wow. Okay.
It just did. I was like, it was bothering me the first verse. I was like, who? What does it sound like? So
I would have never guessed you would have said that. Wow. I thought you were going to refer to some other soul sounding.
Yeah, kind of. I'm not saying they ripped anything off. I think,
no, I know,
you know,
you're not. You're just saying kind of a, keep in mind. I got you.
That's a drive. That's kind of a sort of a, I think, I standard you. Type of beat sort of sound that's been used in zillions of other songs, you know. But anyway, yeah. Anyway, I liked it. I really did funky. It was kind of, I was doing a hip shake off thing, you know, but it's before, you know.
You're doing the hippie shake?
Yeah, you know how the latest, you know, the kids kind of get on and they sort of with their fists, whatever, and they do that. You know, I could definitely see. Yeah, those kids.
The youngsters these days.
Yeah, and there was a descending bass too. That was pretty cool. That was like a bridge between the chorus and the verse. I like that a lot. Descending always gets me. I'm a sucker. And so, yeah, it's a good listen.
Cool.
Good request.
I liked it too. I don't think you can go wrong with this. I don't know what the lyrics are. But as I always say, It's not, that's not a primary importance to me.
I think the lyrics are chinka, chinka, chinka. So there you go. You just go with that.
Yeah.
All right, cool. So I'm going to take
a doing, doing a rehearsal. Like, you put in an extra chinka there.
And with that said, Bob, thanks. This is a really fun request. Thank you. And Chris, thank you. And to everyone out there, we'll see everyone on the next episode of Into the Music.
See you.